Hello and welcome to part one of my WinUAE guide. So this is for anybody that's just starting out with Amiga emulation and you want to learn a little bit more about WinUAE. So eventually I'll be doing some guides on if you're using Linux as well, but today we're going to be looking at emulation on Windows. So I recommend going to this website, winuae.net. And as of the time of this recording, version 4.2 is out. So we need to download the zip archive 64-bit edition. If you know that your machine is quite old and it's 32-bit, then you'll need to download this one. But it's most probable that you need to download the 64-bit version. So the zip archive version, we'll download that. There we go, all done. And the other thing as well you need to look at is getting some kickstart ROMs. So kickstart ROMs are part of the Amiga operating system. So you used to get what was called workbench disks. That was half of the operating system. And the other half was actually on a chip physically inside the Amiga. And this was known as the kickstart. Now you can't get these free off the internet. You can do some Google searching and maybe find some, but officially the way of getting them is going to Amiga Forever, and I recommend getting the Plus Edition pack that they've got, which is going for €29.95 at the moment. It's a really good pack. You get a lot of games with it as well. And actually, if you just want to get into Amiga emulation and just want to quickly play the Amiga and not really delve into the innards of how to set up a custom emulator, then actually this pack is really good for you. Just purchase this, install it, and then you don't really need to carry on with this video. But if you're interested in tinkering about a little bit more and making your own custom setup and exploring the Amiga, then follow along. So you need to buy this pack, download it, install it, and then eventually you will get in your start menu, if I go to Amiga, where is it? Amiga Forever, you'll see Amiga Files. So in here, you'll have a shared folder, a ROMs folder, and in here are all the various different kickstarts. You get this as the Plus pack. If you get the Value pack, then you will only get a very limited amount of ROMs, which I don't really recommend. I recommend that you just go with the Plus pack. Right, so with those done, make sure that's all installed. Kind of make a note of this path because WinUAE is going to be looking for this. Hopefully it will automatically pick it up, but if not, then we just need to make a note of this path. Excellent, right, okay, so with those two main things done, and we've downloaded WinUAE, let's go to that. Let's extract it. I've got 7-zip, so I'm just going to extract it into its own folder. Let's rename that folder Amiga. And inside, we've just got one executable. So let's double click that. Right, okay, and we come to the main page. So there's a lot involved here, so don't worry, it is quite overwhelming for a beginner. We've got a load of menu options down the side and then a lot of configuration here. So we'll start at the top. We've got the about, that's pretty obvious. Paths, right, okay, so if we go to paths, we talked about our kickstart ROMs, it's referred to here as system ROMs, and as you can see, it's auto filled in that path that we just mentioned a minute ago. So if you've downloaded your ROMs from somewhere else, then you need to make sure to put that into a folder somewhere and reference that folder here. So with all of that done, next couple of things we need to do is change this option here. It may be set to user directory by default. We just need to make sure it's set to XC default and then just reset to defaults there. And then make sure that relative paths are ticked and portable mode is ticked. So that's done with that page. Okay, the next one is quick start. And as you can see, it gives you a nice load of set of pre-done templates of various Amiga models. So in this example, we'll choose an Amiga 1200, 4 megabytes of RAM, I think that would do as an expansion. And yeah, pretty much we don't need to do anything more in this. We'll come back to disks in a moment. And then configurations. So once you've set up your Amiga how you want it to be, it's best to save that configuration. So if we go to name, A1200, and click save, there we go, all my settings are saved. So next part, in here we've got two main sections. We've got hardware and we've got host. Okay, hardware is all about the Amiga, so the Amiga hardware, what kind of CPU the Amiga's got, what chipset it's got. So you've got AGA, the original chipset, you've got advanced chipset as well, you've got what ROM it's going to have, how much RAM. So this is all about the Amiga. The next part is host. Now the host is all about the PC side of things, how it interfaces with the Amiga. So the host is all about how it's actually going to be displayed, how it sounds, what game ports is it going to be, because we can set up the joystick to use various keys on a keyboard, or we can actually use an Xbox controller, anything we want really. So that's hopefully going to be pretty obvious to you that there's two kind of sections to this. So you've got the Amiga side and you've got the PC side for the host. So I'll tell you what, let's go to the host side of things. So let's go to display, and at the moment we've got window view and we've got a resolution of 720 by 568. That will do us for the moment. We'll have a play with this later on. There are various ways of doing it. Full screen as well. There's a video that Dan does over on Lemon Amiga. I'll recommend you check that out if you really want to go into detail of changing all the display settings. We're going to keep it nice and simple because this is only part one for the moment. So we'll keep that always standard. Sound, we want sound enabled. Recommend that we untick automatic switching. That can mess about with if you're doing any recording of gameplay at all. And then game ports, what we're going to make sure is that port 2, which is normally where the joystick is plugged in, we're going to just have it for the moment set to keyboard layout A, so that's using the numeric keys. So we want to load up our Amiga. So what do we do? Well, we can click start and then we see the default boot up screen. Excellent. So if we press F12 on the keyboard now, that will get us back to our menu again. So let's try putting in a floppy disk. So we'll go to floppy disks, and then if you've installed the Amiga Forever pack, it also comes with workbench disks as well. Documents, Amiga files, shared, and ADFs. Okay, there we go, we've got all our workbench disks. Let's just put in a workbench disk 3.1. There we go. So disks are represented by what's called ADF files, so Amiga disk files. So the whole disk appears as a file on our PC. And we can also change the speed of the disk. So if you had an original Amiga back in the day, you'll remember that the disk speed was pretty slow. So we can move it all the way to the left and that moves it into turbo mode. Okay, so with that done, what we can then do is reset the Amiga. Now this can be a little bit confusing, these two things here. So we've got reset and we've got restart. Reset resets the Amiga, so it does a control Amiga Amiga. The restart button restarts the emulator and all of the configuration and everything. So if we hit that, any configurations that we haven't saved in here, I'll just click A1200 and save because I've just made some changes. Always remember to save your configurations. Yeah, if we clicked restart, that'll just start afresh. Reset actually resets the Amiga. Hopefully you understand that. So if we click reset, okay, and we just wait a few moments and we should eventually have the workbench screen come up. There we go, there's workbench, nice and clear, excellent. So we can actually play games as well. So games will be available as ADFs as well. A good place to start looking is under the MegaForever.com site. If we go to download games, Dream 17, they have a load of games. We're looking for Amiga ADF files. Let's scroll right down to the bottom. Worms, Director's Cut Image is down there. We download that, and there we go. We've got these ADF files again. So let's copy those to our Amiga folder. We'll tidy up that later. Okay. Go back to our emulator, hit F12, go to floppy disks, and then browse to our Amiga folder, insert disk 1, tick DF1 because we can have extra drives now, disk 2, tick that, disk 3, there we go, so we've got our three disks in there, hit reset again, and that will now load up Worms for us. So that's a basic introduction to WinUAE. We will go into more detail in the next video. We'll have a look at setting up a hard drive in the Amiga and installing Workbench, and then later on Better Workbench. But thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.